Mario Kart 8 for the Nintendo Switch is now out, but should you actually buy it?
No.
There's probably some reason to. But regardless, we're going to be discussing on today's episode of Stuff We Play.
Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which is basically the exact same Mario Kart 8 for the Wii U.
It has all of the DLC, it has 4 new characters. I'd say if you don't own the Wii U version, which seeing as the Wii U sold horribly, then yes, I'd say it's definitely the definitive version, but I guess we should run through some of the other features it has.
I know the only feature that really honestly I thought was exciting was that they've got this whole thing where you can put up bumpers on the side so you're not falling off when you're driving Rainbow Road. That is my big problem. I always fall off the road.
And honestly, I know a lot of purists. I mean, at first I was like, really? But I know a lot of purists are going like, why would they give you that option? But here's the thing where I see that come into play. And maybe this is just how I'm looking at this, but I currently have a niece and nephew. My nephew's almost 2 and my niece is almost 4. And my nephew Dean, not quite yet, but Leela, my niece, for sure, I mean, she already plays Mario Kart with me on occasion.
And I know she gets kind of really upset when she falls off because she doesn't have the controls down yet.
No, I mean, we're talking about a 4-year-old with tiny hands. So, I mean, you have tiny hands too, I can see this very good because Mario Kart is a game for all ages. This makes it more accessible to children. So
it's definitely more age friendly, and I enjoy that.
Yeah, I mean, hey, more excuse to play Mario Kart with the niece, right?
Right.
The other thing that's big is they're putting a proper battle mode in this, which kind of makes me think now. It's like, oh, were they planning this from the get-go? Is that why the battle mode in the Wii U version sucked so badly?
Because was it just something that there was so much complaint about it that they're like, we're gonna go back and fix that?
But then it also makes you think of, well, why not release that as DLC? And you know, I feel kind of gypped as that as someone who owns the Wii U version, and maybe I'm one to talk because I don't actually own Nintendo Switch yet. Because,
right.
I mean, quite frankly, I'm in university, that thing's waiting till Christmas. One of the other big features is that you can now carry 2 items at once, except that's not a big feature. That was in every Mario Kart game beforehand, where, you know, you could trail one behind you and have one.
Yes.
Or you could have 2 at once and double dash, so I'm like, but I think the big selling point here is it's on the Nintendo Switch. You can play it portably.
Yeah, but they're also bringing in the item stealing ghosts, which I think that's actually in the Wii version, which I enjoyed.
Yeah, I don't mind that.
I thought it was cool though, because you know, there's some jerk behind you who has a turtle shell he's getting ready to launch, and you just kind of boom.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
You get it and launch it back at him, and it's like, yeah.
It's like with the sound box thing, you know, that explodey box. I don't know what it's called, because you get a blue shell and it's like, no, not today, destroy your blue shell. But playing Mario Kart portably is definitely a selling point.
Yeah, I think the big thing they're also doing is the handheld, who doesn't want to go play Mario Kart on the toilet? But the problem with that is you can just buy the DS version.
Yeah, but at the same time, that's the other thing. It's like, yes, you can play Mario Kart 8 in the toilet, but at the same time, it's like, I could play Mario Kart 7 on the toilet, and I can do that on a system that's much cheaper and has been out for years now.
Right.
Maybe it's now you have a new Mario Kart to play while you're flushing the, flushing away the contents of today's Taco Bell lunch, you know?
All the Mountain Dew.
Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah, that's right, we're gamers while you're flushing out all that sweet Mountain Dew and Doritos. Yeah. So overall, the final verdict on whether you should buy Mario Kart 8 Deluxe or not is?
Maybe.
And I say that as a very firm maybe, because you either fall into one of 3 categories. The first category is that you own Mario Kart 8 and you don't and you aren't much of a portable gamer. And if that's the case, then this is not the game for you. Because quite frankly, if you own Mario Kart 8, and especially if you own the DLC, unless battle mode was your thing back in the day, you have no reason to own this.
And then you have it,
if you own Mario Kart 8, but say you're one who goes out a lot and you like portable game, which I guess I kind of in that category because it's like, I bring my 3DS, and that one's one where it's most certainly a maybe, because then it's like, well, do I want to play HD games on the bus, or are you too afraid of getting scratched or stolen?
Which would be my thing. Like, I feel like if I had like a Switch on the bus, I'd probably get mugged because I'm a white girl.
Finally, the biggest category is if you own a Switch but you didn't own a Wii U, or if you owned a Wii U but you never owned Mario Kart 8, which is a crime. You need to own a copy of Mario Kart 8 if you own a Wii U, then most certainly need to get it because it is the definitive version.
Yes.
But on the whole, as a game, I feel like it's a cop-out. Quite frankly, I feel like they could have had a Mario Kart 9 or something out, but I feel like it's a lazy release.
Yeah, it could have been its own thing, and instead they're like, nah, we're just gonna redo this.
And I most certainly would say that do not consider this a system seller.
Is your ear bruised?
I'd say that the Nintendo Switch still does not have a firm system seller in my eyes, because yes, it has Zelda, yes, it has Mario Kart 8 now, but those are on the Wii U, which is cheaper at this point. And you know what? The Wii U is a perfectly good system. And it's a shame, because I don't feel like the Switch is going to have a true system seller until Mario Odyssey comes out.
I definitely think, I don't think it's going to be worth it until about Christmas.
I'd still say the biggest thing they should do with the Switch, and GameStop's actually doing this, kudos GameStop, where it's like $50 more and it actually does come with a game.
Yeah.
But I think until at least Mario Odyssey comes out, but especially if Nintendo would finally put a pack-in game with it.
Right.
Like, 1-2 Switch shouldn't be a $70, $80 game. I mean, I'm using Canadian prices here. But it should be a pack-in game, a tech demo, your Wii Sports, Nintendo Land, Mario Duck Hunt, you know?
I don't want to buy a console if I don't have,
something for it.
And
because, and maybe, as I said,
when the games are still new and so expensive.
Absolutely, because we're talking Canadian prices. We're talking $400 for a Switch, and then anywhere from $60 on the low end to $80 on the high end for games. We are getting off topic. Remember, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe might not be for you, so...
With that, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, Instagram, we're on Instagram
all
now.
Those things, links are right here. I can't actually link them because YouTube doesn't do annotations and VidMe doesn't have anything like that. But
so
they're in the description.
In the description.
And remember to like and subscribe if you're on YouTube, follow and share if you're on VidMe, and for just share this if you enjoyed our ramblings. And furthermore, if whether you've bought the game or not, and whether you just think Nintendo's dead at this point, just comment what you think down below.
Yeah.
So is there anything else you forgot?
I have a bun today.
She has a bun. Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen.